Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Kilimanjaro. Today we're going to be climbing Lion's Head and we're going to be doing a cleanup and it's going to be nice and fun. So what brought you out to come hike here and do the cleanup?
Okay, so we're part of an organization called FLAT. It's not Flash Warden, but a lot of people assume it. It basically stands for Friends of Lion's Head and Signal Hill, which is that part. So with that organization, we do regular cleanup. We get Love Our Trails, which is very, very passionate about our trails. And they're also out here today. And it's a collaboration between the different organizations to actually keep this pristine Lion's Head.
So I hear you climbing Kilimanjaro next year.
Where did you hear that? No one knows about it. Where did you? Please tell me. And I'm going to jump. So what we're doing as well, I'm the director of Spin for Charity, which is a non-profit organization registered in 2005. So what we're doing is we basically, I'm busy training at the moment. And the way I train is I've got my mountain bike on my back. I've summited Devil's Peak, Satellite Gorge and Lion's Head already up and down with a mountain bike on my back. And the reason for that craziness, we crazy people.
Yeah.
And we do crazy things. So I'm doing it for abused women, men and children worldwide.
Okay.
And please tell me, little man, I understand that you're also an adventurer of note. And you'll also be climbing Kili. Please tell us about what you do.
So I'm going to be climbing for the memory of all the fallen firefighters that risked their life to for our safety and yeah.
Okay, so just quickly, briefly, why did you decide that? When did you decide it? Did you just wake up one morning and say, voila, I'm going to go now save the firemen by climbing?
No, it all started, I was in church and then when I came out of church,
yes.
I told my dad I want to climb Kilimanjaro and I said to him, you always say if we can dream it, we can do it. Now he thought I was going to forget about it, but
what?
No, I'm not forgetting about it. And then he only realized it's going to get bigger and bigger and bigger.
Awesome, okay. And on that note, I also want to say thank you very much. A 9-year-old taking the initiative, you are going to be our youngest and the best entrepreneur. Need your voice inside my head. Hello, hello, I believe you. How can I forget? Is this a place that I go home to find what I've become? Walk along the path unknown. We live, we love, we lie.
Love Our Trails about 5 years ago. And it started because I do trail running and mountain biking, and I wanted to, well, I noticed that with more people going on trails, there's so much more litter, so much more graffiti, people walking off trails and erosion. And the only way to change that was to change behavior, and the best way to change behavior is through leadership. So I decided to get all my friends and do a cleanup, and that was 5 years ago. And since then we've done, this is our 20th cleanup, and we've picked up almost 2 tons of litter.
So
we're cleaning graffiti off, and I import graffiti from overseas, a graffiti cleaner from overseas. And the reason we like taking graffiti off, or we do take graffiti off, is because of the broken mirror effect from New York, is that wherever there's graffiti and litter, we see an increase in crime and bad behavior. And so if we come down hard on this, on the small things like managing graffiti, removing graffiti as it goes up, we start creating a culture of pride and caring for our environment. So that's why we're all doing this. But also nature needs to be nature, and we can't have everyone writing their love notes and random things and spray paints on our rocks. Like, we come here to see beauty. Yeah, that's our story, and just kind of, I don't know, want more people to engage with nature and do epic stuff that's respected. And hopefully when you climb Kilimanjaro, you can tell all those people. Is this a place that I call home to find what I've become? Walk along the path unknown. We live where